How do natural disasters change a community?
The world was hit by approximately 330 natural disasters in 2017. The Tokai disaster was caused by a massive earthquake that sent a devastating tsunami crashing into the Japanese town of Tokai. Super strong hurricanes lashed the Caribbean islands. Wildfires scarred the US landscape. These kinds of natural disasters have always happened, but climate change is increasing their frequency and ferocity, so it's likely we'll see more reported next year. But what does that mean for communities around the world? Certain areas are more resilient than others. Some mainland states in the US can afford to spend money on flood defenses to lessen the impact of natural disasters like Hurricane Harvey. And they are better equipped to bounce back too, because their infrastructure allows for the entry of first responders. But when Hurricane Maria hit Puerto Rico, insufficient defenses could not withstand 150 miles per hour winds. Homes were leveled and others left without electricity for months. Puerto Rico experienced a humanitarian crisis, with many people at risk of starvation. How can we help countries defend themselves against natural disasters? Geography dictates who is in the path of danger. People living in countries like Qatar, Bahrain, and the United Arab Emirates can go through their lives without ever experiencing a natural disaster. But countries like China, Japan, and the Philippines are statistically more likely to fall victim just because of their location. China, for example, is located in an active seismic zone where major earthquakes are common. How is life different for people living in disaster-prone areas? We've learned that climate change is making natural disasters more common, how nations cope with natural disasters, and how location can put them in harm's way. How can we help communities deal with the aftermath?